Yo, it's Tim from Rough Night Gaming. If you don't know me by now, I'm Toonchi XI Ayot. Hit me up on Xbox. I don't play PSN. No offense to you people. But this is my first commentary. I chose Halo. Get away from the Call of Duty feel. I'm gonna choose a topic today. It's gonna
Take
be
the lead.
Call of Duty versus Halo. There's a lot of people who fight over this topic of
Take the lead.
what's better, what takes more skill, what's more fun. Honestly, they both have their ups and downs. I think Halo, to me, personally, is a better game than Call of Duty. No offense to you Call of Duty fans. I'd enjoy playing it here and there, but I can't stay on it. I get so bored, it's the same thing over and over again. Halo, it changes depending on the players you play with, where you go on the map. Maps change. A lot of people don't camp. I don't know. To me, it takes more skill. You have to lead your shots. You get I don't know, like the DMR in this game. You have to wait for the crosshair to go back and so you can headshot easier so your bullets don't go spread out. Call of Duty, it's pretty much just spray and pray. Oh, fail right there. But, yeah, I think Halo takes more skill only because, like I said, there's you pretty much have to shoot for the head. If you don't shoot in the head, you're not gonna get a kill. People who shoot in the head in Call of Duty, it's pretty much like it's a waste of time. You can take the four shots in the body before you can take two shots in the head, but Halo, you need that headshot. To me, all right. Another thing about it, campaign wise, Call of Duty does not have a campaign whatsoever. The games change, there's multiple characters throughout it. To me, I get really confused on who the fuck I am. Halo, you're one person. You're Noble Six, Master Chief, or the rookie from ODST. So it's like, you know who you're playing as. Or actually, ODST was a little weird. You played as multiple characters through a flashback, but that's besides the point. You usually know who you're playing as and what you're actually doing. Call of Duty, it's like different characters, the feel's different, you're in different places like every other freaking mission. What else can I say? Call of Duty, I love Call of Duty for sniping. I think that's fun as shit. It's just wicked inaccurate, I'll give it that, but it's makes it fun. Modern Warfare 2, I loved quickscoping, that was fun as shit. Oh yeah, speed down. Oh, never mind. Fucking kid stole my kill. But alright. That was fun. I love that. Playing on Rust. I used to play fucking so many private matches with that. Halo Reach. It's fun. I like it. Custom games is pretty fun, but it just gets tiring after a while. Because you don't really have many friends to play with, and the map's usually big. You can't really quick scope with the sniper rifle. It's too accurate to do that, I guess, if I can say that. Yes. But, yeah. What else can I say? Call of Duty multiplayer. Alright, I think Call of Duty has become more of a multiplayer-based game than it has than a campaign game. Me, I love campaigns. Campaigns are my thing. I love stories. Being told stories is what I love. Halo has a perfect fucking storyline. I love it. Halo 3, a little iffy. Halo 2 was great. The ending sucked, I'm not gonna lie. But Halo 1, oh my god. That was a fucking amazing campaign. There is a reason why that was the best first-person shooter game. The campaign was amazing. Everybody loved it. Call of Duty can never uphold Halo's campaign stories. Ever. Sorry. Sorry, Call of Duty fans. But it will never happen. Halo is amazing. I'm sorry. I can't get over the fact that Halo is just so fun. I've been following it since the first game. I've bought in every game they've ever put out. Bought in Halo 1, Halo 2, Halo 3, Halo Wars, ODST, Halo Reach, Halo Anniversary. I think that's everything. But, yeah. Halo Wars, that was a wicked fun game. It's off the original storyline, but is fun as shit. I like those kind of strategy games that make it fun. It was pretty dirty. And yeah, itchy nose. But yeah, what can I say? Halo Reach to me in the campaign was iffy. It had a great storyline, I'm not gonna lie, but the ending just made no sense to me. How it ended, Noble Six dying, spoiler alert if you haven't played the game, is probably the worst idea they could do. I honestly thought throughout the game, Noble Six was going to be the new Master Chief, or was Master Chief at the younger age.
Sniper spree, killing
Who
spree.
know? I know. That's what I thought throughout the whole game. But turns out he was just another Spartan that it ended up dying. It was like a depressing ending. I don't know. Call of Duties, that Black Ops game, was okay. I didn't really like it at all. Some missions were pretty fun. The storyline was like all over the place and didn't make much sense. It kind of reminded me, well, actually, I should say this. Battlefield 3. Sorry. That game was pretty much the completely exact same storyline as Black Ops in every way. Being interrogated and you telling your story. Pretty much, except for like the delusional, like you missing things and you actually thinking a person was there helping you out when there really wasn't. That they really didn't have. But it was pretty much the same thing. And then you escape at the end to go do something. I don't know. It was pretty dumb.
5 minutes
Modern
remaining.
Warfare 3, the ending was pretty cool, but throughout the game it was dumb. I honestly did not know what was going on. I was confused as shit. You were like four other people throughout the game. And in Call of Duty games, you always end up dying. All the characters end up dying except for one person. The main character, I don't know who it usually is. Say Woods in Black Ops. I don't know. He doesn't end up dying, but everybody else pretty much does. Which is pretty much the thing I really don't like about Call of Duty. Other than that, it's a pretty decent game. Except for all the server lag they have that's fucking just dumb as shit. Hold on, we gotta look at this again. I'm sorry, that's pretty boss right there. Fucking no scoped across the map. Headshot. Yeah, baby. But that was pretty dirty. Instantly death out there. Fuck me, right? But, yeah. I'm gonna say multiplayer wise, comparing both games, you can't really compare them. One's more of a fast-paced, quick little maps, while Halo, kind of quick, close corner combat, but it's like it's also wide range. Say like this map right here, which is pretty much Blood Gulch from Halo 1, which I loved. Except there's no trucks. But the guns, it's like two shots, so it's like it moves pretty fast. Halo, not so fast, but it's like depending on the kind of game match. Say if you're playing SWAT, that game moves extremely fast. The game will end over. It will be ending in probably like, say, 5, 6 minutes. You have to aim for the head. If you don't know what SWAT is, it's one shot to the dome. And back in Halo 3, you could shoot them as many times as you want if you didn't hit them in the head and they wouldn't die. But in this game, I actually like how maybe I think it's like 5 shots. If you get hit, you'll die eventually. Halo 3 didn't do that. You could just shoot as many times until you actually hit them in the head. Other than that, yeah. The sniping is not the same whatsoever. Sniping in Halo, too accurate. I shouldn't say too accurate, but it's, I think, the most accurate, like, sniping game out there. But Battlefield 3, that's pretty cool how the bullet drops and you have to like change it by wind speed and stuff. But I say Halo is more accurate. You have that little pinhole that you have to hit in the head. While fucking Call of Duty, you can pretty much just like go into the scope real quick and somehow you get a kill. Or you could shoot like maybe 2 feet to the side of them and still end up getting a kill. To me is ridiculous. I don't really understand that. But hey, it's Call of Duty. It's been like that for years. Okay, we'll go to assault rifles, I guess. Assault rifles, I'm gonna say Call of Duty. I like the wide range of like guns they have. Halo, with the classes and stuff, that's a new thing for them when Halo Reach came out, which I thought was pretty cool. But you only could change the pretty much power up, which I didn't really like that. The powers changed Halo to this point of like I didn't really care for it anymore. Like, it took me a while to get back to Halo Reach. I had to stop, put it back. I had to go back to Halo 3 and play more because I loved Halo 3. Halo 3 was fair to every player. That's another thing I don't like about Call of Duty. It's not fair. It's not even to every player. Halo 4, I mean, not Halo 4, sorry. Call of Duty 4 and WoW were fair. To the point of the fairest Call of Duties that were going, because you had the same amount of kill streaks and stuff. Like, everybody had the same kill streaks. I don't know, it was fair. But, so far, that's all I
Game
got.
over.
Thanks for watching. Comment and subscribe. Tunchi XIA, again, thank you for watching.